What's up, guys, and welcome to episode 7 of my Tampa Bay Buccaneers Connected Careers. And right there, Cam Newton's running onto the field, and he looks like he's having a good season. 14 touchdowns, 5 interceptions, definitely better than Josh Freeman, at least. And he does have a good game here. And right there, the first play of the game, he sets up in the Wildcat and gets a first down. And then throws it to Greg Olsen here, who gets drilled. But actually, they do not do anything on the first their first possession. Right there, Doug Martin, of course, fumbles. Well, not of course, because he really hasn't done much of that this season. But not something you want to see the first drive of the game right there, Doug Martin fumbling. But, I mean, you can't be perfect, right? So there's Dallas Clark again. Dallas Clark has just been a great player for us this season as LeGarrette Blount gets the first down. Maybe a tight end of the year award. And Stocker right there. I'm going to start using him a lot more in the upcoming weeks. He is a tight end, so it will take some time away from Dallas Clark. But Dallas Clark needs the rest sometimes as Doug Martin does not get the first down, and we get the field goal right there. And the only reason why I'm going to be using Stocker more is because, obviously, if there's an injury with Dallas Clark, and because it says he needs a... or it says he wants a contract extension, and I don't know how well he can play. And there's a... right there, 14-3 as they get the touchdown. And a spoiler right there, that is the last points they will score until the fourth quarter. So we just need to make up, 11 points. We just need to make up 11 points by the fourth quarter and we'll be good. If they don't score until the fourth quarter, that shows how good our defense is. And what was I talking about before? I don't even remember what I was talking about before. So, Stocker as he fumbles right there, but we get the ball. I want to see how well he can play before I give him a contract extension and potentially waste my money on something that could be a bust. But you never know with these players. They play until they get the big money contract, as we don't get the... that is a first down. They play, and then they get the big money contract, and then sometimes they don't perform the way they did because they were playing only for that big money contract. But you never know. I mean, Stocker, I wouldn't give a big money contract to anyway, only because he is the backup. But you never know, because Dallas Clark could get a career-ending injury and he would become our tight end. And right there, Doug Martin, second time fumbling in the game. At that point in the game, there was 3 fumbles and I thought there was something wrong in the game. But Doug Martin does get hurt there, so I guess that makes up for it. But not really, because you should hold on to the ball. And I was pressing R1, so I don't know. And then they get a first down there, but nothing happens for the rest of the half as Josh Freeman runs to make it 2nd and 3. And then there's Doug Martin again. Wow, getting by the defense there. He does not fumble, which is good. And running the comeback route is Vincent Jackson. So that's good for him. And then Vincent Jackson again with the the comeback route. And then Bennett gets a sack because we did not get anything going on that drive after that play. So Bennett forces the fourth down. And Doug Martin again with the first down, 63 yards rushing. He does not fumble, which is good. And then Doug Martin again, we pass it to him, 3rd and 2. And then LeGarrette Blount. Oh, wow, nice little move there, but... gets it to 4th and 1, and we go for it, and LeGarrette Blount gets the first down. LeGarrette Blount is our 12th man of the year. He's become an outstanding player for the role that we need him in, which is good. You always need a good player like that, like a good backup that could come in as a starter if needed, and I think he could if needed. So right there, a screen to Doug Martin. He doesn't fumble because there's nobody around him, and he gets the touchdown. So it's 14-10, and now we just need to make up 4 points And Cam Newton throws his, sixth interception of the season. And the flag right there is only because of face mask on that tackle. So right there, Josh Freeman passes to Vincent Jackson, and we get a touchdown. So it is 17-14 now. We just need to hold this lead. Our defense has been playing very well throughout the game, but not right there on the first down. And that is the last play of the third quarter. It is, and we get to the fourth quarter, fourth and three. And then Doug Martin gets the 9 yards, 83 yards, I think that said he had, and then he gets the first down. I don't know why I didn't have LeGarrette Blount in there, but it doesn't matter because Stocker does not make the catch on a bad throw, but that doesn't matter as, Redmond gets drilled. And then Steve Smith gets hit again hard. Time is ticking for the Panthers to try and get something going here, and he should have been tackled all the way back there at 2nd and 20. There was a offsides or something penalty on first down. But look at that. We are lucky that he did not get through that because that probably would have been a touchdown. 1 minute and 16 seconds left on the clock. Can we do anything before it goes into overtime, if it goes into overtime? And a nice pass to Dallas Clark. Three people get knocked down. And then, Josh Freeman gets sacked, but we go for it on fourth down. Vincent Jackson breaks a tackle. And he will go all the way, but I'm not doing that because that would leave time on the clock. So Vincent Jackson gets tackled with 2 seconds left. Gets the game-winning field goal. So I just want to thank you guys for watching. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, favorite, and share. And I will see you guys in my next video. And also follow me on Twitter. Thank you guys.